my sincere pleasure to introduce our next guest. Reem Abu Saif is a visual storyteller. She is an amazing photographer, and she is a woman with huge heart who really wants to bring everyone's story to life and to your memory forever. Reem, welcome, and thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you so much for having me.
It is a pleasure. It is such a pleasure. As the world is opening back up and people are coming out of our shells and we are really coming back out into the world, I know I'm not the only one who really had a deep sense of needing to document this time in our lives, and especially in my own life, just a day in the life, right? The opportunity to capture what's new going forward, and also to put so much importance on capturing these moments and having them forever. And no one does it better than you. Thank you so much for the beautiful work you did for me.
I want to
hear about your story. How did you get here?
Well, it's an interesting story. I studied graphic design in Virginia two decades ago. And then I got married and had babies right away. I had three children. I wanted a baby girl, so I kept getting boys. And I kept trying again and again, three times. I didn't get the girl, but I decided that's it. So 10 years after, I decided to look after myself and use my degree as a graphic designer. But I was way behind. All the technology had moved so fast. So all my Photoshop, even the software I was editing, is like nobody know what Quark Express is and all these names. So I found a hard time. Either I had to start over or just use a skill that I have. And the only skill that I practiced through the 10 years was photography. I had three beautiful children, and I was taking a lot of pictures of them, documenting their life, posting and using social media for that. And I kept getting comments about, like, you really have a skill, you have an eye, why don't you take it to the next level? So one day after my youngest one went to preschool and I had nothing to do, I decided I'm going to take it to the next level. And this is how I started.
That's an amazing story. And I think all of us can relate to feeling like we want to capture moments of our own family, of our own situation, our own events, but being that storyteller for someone else, being able to see into the heart of your subject and find exactly the moment to capture, that's a completely different skill. So while you may be a super photographer and take pretty pictures, what you do is much deeper. And how did you evolve to that?
It was a long journey. Like, I wasn't really good when I started. I started for free, offered it for a friend and family. I did a lot of friends, like special occasion, anniversary, wedding, engagement, newborn, maternity. And with every session, I will discover a weakness that I need to work on. So I invested a lot on myself. I used to do online classes all the time. My kids recognized some of them, famous photographers, from The Voice. Like, they told me, oh, you're listening to this or this. So I did that. And I also, I got a positive feedback from a lot of people saying, like, you were really, like, you know, you really figure out what his favorites, like, way to smile or how to do this and that. So I learned from that. And having three kids of myself, it was very easy. I started with kids. I did first the newborn and maternity for the first 2 years of my photography career. But then I start to lose the spark. I just needed something else. Like, I wasn't too enjoying it the way I wanted to do photography. I want to take it to the next level. So I kept changing. I tried headshot. I tried product photography. I did a little bit of everything until I got to the fashion. And this is when I found myself like, okay, I know how to present someone with the self-image. What is the beauty? Like, I look at someone and I kind of know that, oh, they speak with their eyes, or a beautiful smile, or, you know, the way they do this and that. And this is what really started the whole thing. Like, I get to know my client before I photograph them in a one-to-one level. And before even carrying my camera, I knew what to focus on.
It's an amazing journey to watch you from the start to the end product. And we're going to send people to your website because your fashion photography is extraordinary, but your personal photography really, really brings forth the heart of your subject. And so if people are looking for you, where can they find you now?
Social media, everywhere. I have my own website, which is Studio Reem, and I use the same name for all my social media. So I am on Instagram as well as Facebook under Studio Reem. I also recently I keep changing stuff. So I wanted to challenge myself again. So I am into fine art photography. So I also started fine art photography by Studio Reem. And this is a new thing that where I do your session, but in the end of it or part of it, I take very different kind of pictures with different lighting and I edit differently to fine art. So that's a new approach I'm doing.
That sounds so exciting. We didn't get a chance to do that, but we will.
We will. It needed more of lighting and studio lighting. So we did our session outside. We didn't have time to do the indoor, but for the future, we will.
Yes, we definitely will. And you bring up a really good point. Everyone is so busy on social media, telling their story, sharing their story. Give me one or two tips that our viewers could use right now, even if they're just taking their pictures with their iPhone, what should they focus on to really tell a great story of their own?
You know, social media these days are very tricky because a lot of people wanted to show the happy moments and like looking amazing, almost like fake. And I don't like that because, you know, I like to show genuine emotions. And my advice is just be you. Like if there is something that you're celebrating or you emotionally feeling it, just express it. If that's how you wanted your friend and family feel you in a good days and a bad day and an okay day. The second advice I will do is with the COVID, things has changed so much. And a lot of people were not comfortable like sharing their pictures or taking their pictures or telling their stories. But really it's a, like I hardly have any guests coming to my home for the last year. So my only way to communicate and show my friends and talk to them is through images and through social media. So use it wisely, be yourself, be honest with yourself and others, and definitely take pictures also with your family. Because lots of people like gain weight, one of them is me, or not comfortable. I'm really like, today I had a hard time like being behind the camera instead of roof and in front of it, you know, like, or the opposite, in front of the camera instead of behind it. So just like be comfortable and take pictures because this is, picture stays forever and really it's great memories. And I look at my own photography pictures from like a few years ago that I didn't like. And now after I gained the weight and I got older, I look back and it's like, this is a great picture. Why I didn't use it?
Right. I thought I was heavy then. Oh my goodness. What was I thinking?
Yes. Yeah. So just be yourself and use your social media wisely and, you know, tell the story in like from your point of view in an honest way. And that's my advice.
That's great advice. Thank you so much. And Reem, thank you for coming on to share. We're going to put your website up on the screen so our viewers can find you. And I'm sure they'll be looking for you on social media also. So keep your eyes open. I know there are going to be some people looking for you.
I appreciate it. Thank you so much for having me.
It's a pleasure.